again. In this tutorial I will show you how to go from a 2D flat curve drawing to 3D models, 3D objects. This is quite easy. When you already finish your shape, I've done it kind of bubble shape in previous tutorials, so you will get something quite smooth and nice in the modeling. So I'm going back to from my top view to my perspective to show you how does it look on the perspective window. So if you right press the mouse and just move the mouse, you can turn around your created curve and see how it looks and where is places on the axis gumball. So to make it 3D, it's very simple. You just need to go to your options called extrude, and if you have something called extrude tray, if you select the curve, you're just extruding. I had a default on the boat size extruding, which is sometimes helpful, but I will just explain everything right now. Look, if you want to, again, if you want to go back to this comment and do it step by step, so look, just select option extrude straight and look, the software telling you what to do. Select curves to extrude. Here you are. I selected. And if you select it, press enter. Enter is already this all also right button of your mouse. And then here on pointers, you've got many more options. For example, boat size. Look, it's yes. If you just click it, you're selecting and changing on only one side. You see? Okay, let's stay. You stick with no in both sides. Cup is the bottom and top filleting of the shape, which if you selecting no, it will be just surface, not solid. So I prefer to go with yes, because I want to have a cups. And delete input means to delete the curve which this shape is created from. Direction is direction of extruding, but I don't want to change direction right now. I want just be planar, and this is it. So also, if you just make any dimension, like a 50, for example, your object will be created at 50 millimeters high. So after you finish your comment, you've got, if you just open your Rhino, you've got your view in wire, not in wireframe, not in shading. So to change it, you have to just right press on the window name, on your view name, and then change it for example, for shading. And then everything is changing for shading view, which actually gives you more information about your design. So now you know how to extrude just straight. So it's many more options. I'll just tell you right now. So I just delete the solid by just selecting and deleting, and then I'll go to the same sets of comments, which is surface and extrude, and look, here you can extrude the object along curve. But you have to have this curve. I don't have the curve yet, so I have to create it. But first, I'll show you how to do it in different shapes, like extrude tapered, for example, or just make a pyramid. So extrude to point. So look, extrude tapered works almost exactly the same like extrude straight, apart that you have to select the angle of your extrusions. Look. Now it's set it for -5 degrees. I want to have degrees changed for 20. So I have to press press the draft angle and then write 20, press enter and look. In this case you cannot do too big the extrusion, because otherwise it would self-intersect, which is wrong. So let's stick with maximum 10. So you can just straight write 10 and press enter. And look what happened. I didn't select the cap, which is important. I want to have it solid. So I have to delete it again. And delete it and do it again. So let's go. Extrude top rim. Look. Press enter. And I'm going to make a cap. No, for yes. And then just make a high 10. Here we are. So this is the second option of creating the solids out of the car in a very simple way. Okay, I'll delete it and we'll show you the next one, which is actually extrude to point, but I don't... we're just creating point, look. See, the point is created. Unfortunately, you have to create... Unfortunately, you have to create in different view. So if you have a planner on, the shape will be, let's create in front. Look, see, this is actually in my designing process. I never use this kind of creating, because this is not useful. But in some design processes, maybe you're gonna use it. I'm not using. So I'm using much often. Extrude along curve, which is that one. So now I will show you how to do it. So you have to create the curve to gonna be like a sweep. So I'll just create the arch with 2 points and curvature from near somewhere or from end, whatever. Let's do it here. And if you have a planner, the next point, look here, will be created at the same planner. The same planner plane. I want to have kind of this shape. Look, always look in perspective window. It will tell you if you are, if you have everything right done. So all right, I'm done with the second curve, and I'm going to straight to my surface creating, and I'm going to make a. I'll extrude along curve. So look, select curve to extrude, enter, which is also right mouse button, and then select path curve near start, which is this one. Look, and again, I didn't select the cap, so it's happened because I'm making right now surfaces. The same comment is also in solids. Look here. But in solids, this is automatically capped. But you can also unselect, which is the same thing. But probably directed to the surface and to the solid comment. Okay, I just go back and make caps. I need a solid. All right, it's here. Alright, enter. Remember to confirm your choice between selecting, and I did it again. And curve to extrude, enter, and now we have to select cap, yes. Alright, and we've got solid. Solid is the feature which is now manufacturable, which, for example, you can print 3D print, you can manufacture by machines, CNC machines, and all this stuff. The surface is not the right thing to do it. So the process of designing is always goes from curves to the solid, because the solid is the volume. Solid have a inside volume. Solid have a really every industrial and every manufacturable properties. So remember to go always to go to the soil. All right. So thank you for watching. You learned how to make a solid out of the curves today. In the next tutorial, I will show you how to work with solids, how to fillet it and how to trim it, how to use boolean difference and all this interesting modification. Thanks for watching. See you later.